willkommen. Das Maschine ist sehr wirksam und nicht so sehr schön. What I just said is this machine is very, very powerful, but maybe not quite as pretty as the last Pfaff that we sold on eBay. This one has a rougher finish on it, but let me tell you something about this machine that surpasses any machine that I've sewn on, whether it's Singer, Husqvarna Viking, Nietzsche, or Pfaff. It's got a motor that I think if you could fit a patio block underneath that presser foot, it would sew through it. It actually has a 1.3 amp motor that peaks at 1.5 amps. The biggest, strongest machine that I can recall us selling on eBay, maybe with the exception of the Husqvarna Viking green machines that also have that 1.5 amp motor. Unbelievably powerful. I'll tell you what, let's go ahead and start on the bottom right hand side right near this knob. This knob right here is to simply raise or lower the feed dogs. If you're wanting to do freehand embroidery, it's a real simple step to simply turn it, they drop down, and you turn it back the other way, and they pop back up again. This is your control for light. By simply pushing it in, you can turn the light on or off. It's got a wonderful lighting system that really does an excellent job of lighting up that entire bed and also the needle area as well. If we come up the right side of the machine, right to this area, this is the control center for two different functions. One is it's going to allow you to sew in reverse. If you simply rotate this all the way to the left, you're going to be going in reverse, and then simply bring it back to the right again to resume sewing forward. It's also going to give you control over that stitch length by simply moving this either right or left. You're going to be able to get as far down as 5 stitches per inch and as tiny as 30 stitches per inch. So the range on this Pfaff 332 is actually wider in stitch variation for length than any of the Singer machines that Singer ever made. And that can make a difference depending on what your project outcomes in fact are. Let's go ahead and take a look at an applique that we did that will show you how beautifully this machine sews. Towards the middle of the applique, you can see that we're probably pretty close to that, probably around 10 to 15 stitches per inch. And as we move to the outer borders, we're getting real close to that 6 to 7 stitches per inch. In some places, a little bit smaller than that. But the final result is just a beautiful applique. It's simple, but it really illustrates nicely what a machine of this quality can generate with a project. And because of the quality of this machine, you are just as able to generate a project like this very quickly as we are. I normally never show a foot control, but I thought that this foot control was so unique, and I'm going to kind of turn it like this towards the camera. It really reminds me of a foot control like you would see, a pedal you would see in a large truck or a bus, and it's heavy enough it probably would work in a bus or some other heavy vehicle. But it's just an indication of the quality, the engineering, the ruggedness of this Pfaff 332 all the way down to the foot control. As with all of our machines, we always try to include an instruction manual for two purposes. One is it's going to help you to maximize that machine so you can fully enjoy the full capacity of what that machine is able to do. It's also going to help you maintain that machine. Now, when you get this Pfaff 332, don't even concern yourself with that, because we have spent about 12 hours on this particular machine going through it inside and out. And I'll tell you one thing, as I went through this machine, I could not believe the engineering of it. Everything forged steel. I mean, it is the epitome of an industrial grade machine. And like I said, could sew patio blocks if you could fit them underneath the presser foot. But as that routine maintenance ultimately comes due, this book will guide you through the very simple steps of maintaining this 332 at the optimal sewing level that you receive it in. And as far as the versatility of this machine, I'm just going to show you real quick, and I know these are rather rough looking, But I wanted to at least show you, while through these videos, we're not going to be focusing on the decorative or the utility side of what this 332 can do. I wanted to at least give you an idea of what the output of this machine is possible, what output is possible. All of these stitches that you can see through the camera right here, by making simple settings, can be generated by this machine. These are all single needle, and then on top of that, you have access to all of these double needle sewing stitch patterns as well. When all is said and done, you end up with 80 plus various stitch patterns, and when you factor in stitch variations, it's practically limitless. And rather than this rough copy that we'll certainly include with the machine so that the owner can, from day one, can start accessing some of these decorative utility stitches, if you decide you want that part of that machine, you can always invest in one of these easy access dial-a-stitch stitch cards. This particular card is not for this machine, which is why we're not including it, but you can readily on eBay and other places find a dial-a-stitch stitch card like this that applies to the Pfaff 332, and then in a more aesthetic way, be able to dial those stitches up and be able to access that full capacity of the machine. Let's go ahead and go back to the machine again, and we've already covered this area over here. Let's go up to this area here, and I'm not going to talk a lot about this simply because our focus on this machine is more heavy-duty leather sewing, you know, really talking about the power of that motor and focusing on what it can do from a heavy-duty leather sewing or heavy-duty sewing capacity. But these are important, an important part of the machine as well. So let me grab that dial-a-stitch card again and just quickly give you a quick illustration of how these are going to function. Let's say, for example, you wanted to pick this particular stitch pattern here. With setting various set points, underneath here you've got set point D, which is kind of hard probably for the camera to see. You just rotate this back and you can access that and set the appropriate number. You're then going to set set point E, which is this control area right here, C, and then in certain instances, like with blind hem stitches, this is going to be a limitation as far as how far that zigzag can reach, and then you might have to make a fine adjustment on that. But to do those various set points, it takes just a matter of seconds, even with our rough paper copies. And if you get a hold of one of these, it'll make it even quicker. But that's what will allow you to access those various decorative and utility stitches. Along with that, for basic sewing, this control right here is going to give you needle alignment. Moving it up or down will give you either a left alignment, right alignment, or in the center where we have it right now. And then for basic sewing, zigzag and straight, you'll use this to control the stitch width. Also, a kind of a cool little feature, if the camera kind of shoots over this area, you can see also for changing the light bulb, should it burn out, you simply rotate this one and the light bulb drops down so you can more readily remove it and then insert a new one. And it's not a specialized bulb. You could probably pick up a replacement bulb for this at most sewing centers very inexpensively. Okay. So let's go to the top of the machine real quick, and I'll just point out a couple of things. We've got one of these spool pins. Both of them are collapsible. You can see that, which is nice so that you're less likely, if you're moving the machine around, you're not going to snap one of them off. So you see two spool pins. You right away know that you can do dual needle sewing. The other feature of this 332, and I believe the 230 can do it as well, is you could even potentially do three needle sewing with it as well. Pfaff is always one step ahead in my experience when it comes to engineering. So you can imagine with this machine being born back in the late 1940s, specifically 1949, to already have that technology capacity in place is pretty doggone amazing. But that's German engineering, and that's what I probably like most about Pfaff machines, is every aspect of the machine is built to last a lifetime. They really don't even take into consideration the need for parts, because in all likelihood, unless the machine is misused, the machine is just going to sew and sew and sew and sew. All right, follow me over here to the left. You can see the threading is pretty easy. You're going to go through this one thread guide right here, kind of loop it through this next one, down through the tension control area, all the way up to the arm, and then all the way down to the presser foot area. Look at the clearance under that. It's absolutely crazy. I've got my finger almost all the way underneath there, and beyond that, there's also a modest hyperextension beyond that. So when it comes to clearance, if you're looking to do lots of layers of quilt batting, if you're looking to do several layers of thick material, whether it's vinyl, whether it's leather, whatever it is, you can fit unbelievable thicknesses underneath that presser foot. Another very unique feature of this machine that I think is way cool, you've seen the Husqvarna Vikings where you can detach the bed and have that access to the free arm. Very seldom do you see one that collapses down and folds up against the inner part of the harp area of the machine. You simply pull it out. I'm going to do this kind of slow so you can see it. Rotate it down just like a garage door, basically, and it's going to slide flat just like that. And that way, if you need to access the bobbin area, there's the bobbin area right there. If you need to simply do some cuffs or something else that requires a free arm, get your jobs done, and then just as easily, you're going to go ahead and bring this back up and lock her back into place again. And then you can resume sewing again using this wonderful extension bed. Huge amount of workspace, both in the harp area from left to right, vertically, and then also off the end of the bed as well. The workspace is just unmatched by very few machines that I've had a chance to work on. Now, if this isn't enough, going through this machine and talking about that 1.3 amp motor that peaks at 1.5 amps, 80 plus decorative utility stitches built in. You don't have to add a cam to this machine. The cams are all engineered inside of that, inside of the housing of the machine, and simply by setting those different points I showed you, you got 80 plus stitches. If that's not enough to get you excited about winning this machine, we're going to add a sweet bonus to this one as we did on the previous Pfaff. And I will do my best to balance all this yummy stuff. There's part of it right there, and another wonderful package of chocolate bars as well. These are all from Germany, as is this Pfaff 332. So as with the other Pfaff, we got some great feedback from the winner. What a great treat it was, taking project breaks in that, enjoying the yummy chocolate. So the winner gets the machine plus all of this delicious chocolate as well. Make sure you check out our other videos as well, where we're going to be showing you the incredible power of this machine that I have affectionately named Samson.